10-minute rule motion, Mr. Edward Leigh.
Mr. Speaker, I beg to move that leave be given to bring in a bill to amend the protected characteristics in the Equality Act 2010 to include a person's conscientious beliefs about the definition of marriage and for connected purposes. Yeah. Within my office, Mr. Speaker, we call this the Adrian Smith Protection Bill, because it was his case that prompted me tabling this 10-minute rule bill. Let me read an extract from the letter that Adrian Smith has written to Members of Parliament. I'm a housing manager who was demoted and had my salary cut by 40%, all because I said on my personal Facebook page that gay weddings in churches would be an equality too far. I wrote those four words using my own computer, outside work time, on a page that was not visible to the general public, yet my bosses at work still saw fit to punish me. I tried reasoning with my bosses, but they dug their heels in. I was left with no option but to go to court to clear my name. It took the better part of 2 years, which was a living nightmare for my family and me. In November, the High Court ruled in my favour, but they didn't have the power to order my reinstatement. So I was left in a demoted job which carried a lower salary. I have now found a job with a different employer. I shouldn't have been treated like an outcast, and my family shouldn't have had to suffer like they did.
So that's why I'm bringing this bill
to protect people like Adrian Smith. His case cost him and the charity supported him £30,000. He got £98 worth of damages. And he was told by those lawyers advising him that he would be unlikely to win his case for unfair dismissal because of recent rulings by the Court of Human Rights in Strasbourg. Indeed, one of those cases, the Lily Liddell case, went against that lady. She was told by the Court of Human Rights in Strasbourg that she had no right, in fact, to have her views on marriage respected at work. She was dismissed by Islington Borough Council, who employed her, even though they could have easily given that particular part of her work to other employees. So this ruling of the Court of Human Rights means an employee who is ordered to go against their conscience on marriage has few, if any, legal rights to protect them. That is why we need an amendment to the Equality Act. There is already a problem. If the government succeeds in redefining marriage, the problem will get much worse. And we're told, of course, Mr. Speaker, that this bill is to be fast-tracked and that, therefore, full scrutiny on the floor of the House is not welcome. But this bill is not some obscure change in the law. It raises profound ethical matters, moral matters, and I would argue constitutional matters affecting the Church of England, and indeed matters concerning conscience. So we need full scrutiny on the floor of the House. And I hope that the opposition will also press for that. And I, for one, will support them if they do. But I've got this opportunity today, Mr. Speaker, a week before second reading, to get on the record the deep concern that exists about freedom to conscience. And I believe that the right to freedom to conscience is as important as protection of church weddings. And the government's bill, as presently drafted, does nothing to protect ordinary people's conscientious views. So Adrian Smith and Lily Liddell can be mistreated at work. The bill offers them no protection. These people should be protected. Indeed, Aidan O'Neill, QC, has produced a legal opinion pointing out that NHS and army chaplains can argue their case for traditional marriage in church on Sunday, but they could find themselves in trouble in their workplace on Monday for articulating the same views. For instance, marriage charities that were set up to promote traditional marriage at a time when nobody dreamed that there was an alternative could find themselves possibly being shut down. Only this week, the very last Catholic adoption agency in Glasgow, St Margaret's in Glasgow, was ordered by the Scottish charity regulator to drop its policy of requiring prospective adopters to be married for 2 years. And according to a leak from the Department of Education, the officials are worried that teachers are going to be in the firing line if marriage is redefined. Indeed, the Secretary of State for Culture, my right honourable friend, was pressed on this very point by John Humphreys on the Today programme last week. And she said, and she admitted, that even in religious faith schools, state schools, even in RE lessons, Teachers would have to teach this subject in what she quotes is a balanced way. Well, many people believe in this country profoundly that traditional marriage is between a man and a woman, and they want to have the right to teach that in school. Because the Education Act requires schools to teach about the nature of marriage. If marriage is redefined, they will be required to teach the nature of same-sex marriage. Teachers who decline will find themselves in the firing line in the same way as Lillian Liddell did. And why should we put thousands of teachers at risk of dismissal for believing that marriage is between a man and a woman? And I believe that Labour and the teaching unions will find themselves in a firestorm if we do not protect their own members. Indeed, extant counsel's opinion tells us that the courts are unlikely to rule in favour of parents who want their children excused from classes teaching same-sex marriage. So this is not, then, a blocking measure to stop same-sex marriage. It simply inserts in the Equality Act protection for a person's conscientious views on the definition of marriage. It would protect those who hold the traditional view that marriage is between a man and a woman. It would also actually protect people who hold a contrary view. But their right to belief and their conscientious right to freedom of expression has to be protected. It doesn't mean, by the way, that a person's conscientious views override all other considerations. It simply says that conscientious beliefs about the definition of marriage are a protected characteristic that must be taken account of. So, I believe that we need to protect the right of conscience. Atheist teachers have, for a century, been allowed to express their opinions. No one can force an atheist teacher to teach religion, and no one has been able to do that for over a century. Pro-life doctors cannot be forced to participate in abortions. During World War II, when we were in a life and death situation, we allowed the existence of conscientious objections. But in 21st century Britain, woe betide anyone who refuses to declare full support for same-sex marriage in their workplace or in the classroom. In my time in Parliament, I have battled for freedom of speech. We had a great victory on Section 5 of the Public Order Act. This is not a fringe concern. No. We go round the world, and we just heard this statement about Mali. We go round the world investing blood and treasure to extend freedom. Let's not forget the freedom on our own doorsteps. And some honourable members who support redefining marriage may be utterly convinced about the rightness of their cause. I respect their views, but they must be generous, surely, towards those who disagree with them. They should ensure that law respects people's deeply held beliefs and not tramples over them. Now, millions of our fellow citizens believe passionately in marriage. They believe their own marriage defines who they are. They don't want their marriages redefined over their heads by politicians. They believe that history, biology, ethics, and religion all tell us that marriage is uniquely a coming together of one man and one woman for life to the exclusion of all others. I believe that these people are entitled to protection. They are entitled to protection not just in their churches. They are entitled to protection in their workplace, at home, on Facebook, and when they are teaching in the classroom. They are entitled to talk about their beliefs about marriage. These beliefs are mainstream, they are sensible beliefs, and they should do so without fear. If we don't, then, believe in freedom of speech for those we disagree with passionately, then I believe we have no passion for freedom of speech. I beg to move.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.